Morning, someone. I just thought I'd do a bunch of small videos of me making stuff. This is the table for the dining area. I've extended the dining room out that way because what I'm thinking is I'm going to spin the table around by 45 degrees so it's that way, and I'm going to make it a six-place table, so with end chairs if I can squeeze it in there. In fact, let me just spin that round. I could get six end was probably the boss on the end there or something like that. Anyway, well, jury was out. And I might even extend this one out so this room and that room become the new VIP area. We'll see. I want to try and keep it as, what's the word I'm looking, cozy as possible. So we'll see how it goes. I might even not extend that room out. I might just extend it out to there. But it does meet making custom modules, half modules. Which I can do because I can borrow all the stuff that I made for Elixir. Anyway, at the moment, I'm creating a leg, a version of my chair, and at the moment, I'm creating a leg. All that was a square cylinder that I've added. When you have a cylinder, you just go patch, insert columns or, let me turn this music down, columns or rows. So basically, all I'm doing here is just trying to recreate that leg. So I've already done one side of it, and I think I've done pretty well there. I've obviously added a little bit of flare here and there. Fact, we could move these ones in a bit. There we go. Move these out a bit. In fact, what I'm going to try and do, this is when I do stuff like this, you're never going to get something exactly right, and you could spend all day trying to get it exactly right. But in this instance, what I want to do is I want to try and snap all of the points, the vert points, to no lower than grid one. On that instance, that's probably not going to be possible for that leg piece there. Let's try it anyway. Oh, it did. Happy days. What about all these ones? It just means that when you're moving stuff around. Alright, those two are going to have to be at the next grid below, unfortunately. It keeps everything. When you move it around, you get less what's called vert drift when you start moving. Now, you don't really get that with patches. But it's a good habit to get into because when you start trying to do what I'm doing, but with brushes, oh man, vert drift, it can, to put it bluntly, can seriously fuck up your model. So if you can, try and create stuff with patches when you're doing intricate stuff like this, because trying to do it with brushes is just a fucking nightmare. You create it, it gets perfect. And unless you export the thing as a model, every time you move it around in DR, all your vert points get fucked up. So, alright, let's do these ones now. So basically, all I'm doing here is, oh, I didn't want to do that. That's the other little top tip. When you're moving vert points, remember to be careful not to put one over the top of the other, because sometimes you can then can't grab that. The vert point you just covered, I that one there that I almost got covered. So that's something to be aware of when you're moving stuff around like this or moving vert points around. Right, those two can stay where they are. go down one grid. Get it. Yeah, I think that'll do. Almost. Let's move those in a bit. No, that just looks stupid when I do that. Let's move that one in instead. There we go. Grand. Right, there's my custom leg. Now, what you could do in this instance is you could just grab the texture where you go looking in media and you go other materials. The texture for this table will be in there. But I already know that texture. I've seen it before on other things. So I might just take a bit of artistic license and change the texture that's applied. Because trying to copy it off that table, it was a bit of a nightmare. So there's an easy way to do this, by the way. If you need to see what the texture is called, what you do is go into that, goes choose model, and there you can see, or in this case, it's not really a good example. Normally you can see the texture. Oh, in this case, D-Table 1. That's the name of the texture. Right, sorry, take it back. Some models have more than one texture applied to it. There you go, look. So that one has rivet strip, floral arches, build and blah, blah, blah. You see the point. So that you can see if you wanted to replicate that model yourself and scale it down but keep the textures looking the same, but you want to keep your collision and shadows working, then this is how you would do it. That's how I've done it multiple times. Right, so what was it? D-Table 01. Right, let me move my little leg. Mirror that in the X. Yep. Oh, it needs to go in one. Is it in the same place? Yeah, pretty much. Could go across one actually. Here we go. No, I'll leave it where it is. As long I'm a great advocate of symmetry. There you can see it's three out from the edge of that trim there, and it's three out from there as well. So three there, grand. Let's hide that table, move these legs. Now I want to make it three piece, so one, two, three. So I'm going to put them in those two corners there instead of these. So I'm reducing it from an eight place table to a six place table. Then I'm going to mirror it again to flip it and make sure it's three in. And I'm going to have to decide where I put that extra trim in. So let's hide that table. Grab these. Do verts. Change it up to grid four so I don't go all over the shop. Go down to one. Grab my feet. Move them up. There we go. Three from there, three from there. Now that's symmetrical. Oh, I've gone down a bit. Oh, I see. I'm being... Yeah, the modelling of that table is a bit lazy. In real life, you wouldn't have a big solid piece across the bottom like that, like there was in the model, which is what I've done. So, what would real table manufacturers would do? In fact, let me just line all my little feet up. One sec. There we go. Three, 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 three. Is they would place a block underneath the feet like that. That's what would happen in real life. That's what I'm going to do for here. Now, I know what some people have probably immediately thought, and I've just thought of it, is model complexity. There's a point where you want to go, right, I'm being a bit too realistic here and I'm causing massive amounts of triz, but in this case, four little blocks. I don't think it'll make any difference, but when the player crawls under the table, they get a sense of realism. Right, let's grab the edge of the table. There we go, there's our little six-way table with no texture on it. Now the reason it's gone no... Sometimes DR will do that, it'll create a brush that you're working on or patches with no textures. So, I can get rid of that table now. Just move it up out of the way so that I'm looking at the one I'm working on there. Nothing's in its way in any of the X, Y or Z axes. Right, let's go look for D-Table 01. So, let's just say, one way you can do it is you can, there you go. Sometimes that works, like it did in this instance, other times it doesn't. Oh, there's a light version of it as well. That's interesting. You know what? This is a light room. Let's make a light ver. Let's choose the light version. Right. Now, obviously, the texture is going to be all over the shop. Yep. So I'm going to have to. Oh, appear properly on the edges. That's handy. What you can do is Control Alt T gives you brings up the texture tool. So what I'm going to do here is I want it to line up with that the edge of this thing here and not have it where it is there. So one two things you can do. If the texture inside in this instance is inside those grids, just click on all the verts and go snap. There we go. Now the top one is done, but now the bottom one is slightly out. Where is it? You know what, I'm going to flip that round. Again, artistic license, it's which way is it round? Yeah, it's that way on this table, but I don't like the hard edge between that texture and that texture. So I'm going to flip it round on my version. Looking nice. Let's get this. That's way too much texture. Oh, that's going to be a pain in the arse. There's the tabletop texture. And that's going to stretch the crap out of it when I try apply it to this table. Now I've just decreased the grid size. Ugh, the texture tool is annoying sometimes. Just doesn't snap stuff properly to the grid. What are you doing, stupid tool? Yeah, look, so it does, it snaps it up the top there, but then when I try to snap the bottom one, it fucks about with it. So the only solution there is just to keep lowering the grid until... No. Oh, fucking... I swear to God, sometimes things in DR... Now, is it going to snap that one out and move the bottom one? No, it isn't. And I try to control Z it to undo the change, and then it fucking zooms the mode, the viewpoint. Yeah, thank you, DR. Right, on the tabletop. I don't know how that's going to look in game. We might have to tweak that. Is that the edge of the texture? Yes, it is. Let's check the other edge. Yeah. And then what you can do is as the tabletop's going to be a brush, I can just paste that to the underside, and it. And it doesn't quite line up, but enough that all I've got to do is just drag it across. Round. Now, if I wanted to be extra, what's the word I'm looking for? You know, I think I will do that. I was going to say I could create a square brush. Sorry, a square patch, and it would mean I wouldn't have to... Let me just group that first so I can show you what I mean. See, there's a surface on the top of these. In fact, I'm going to make these square blocks that and that out of cylinders. So let me do that. Watch, I'll show you. So you just select it, go patch, crates, more cylinders, create square cylinder. Job done. Get rid of the brush. And now all I have to worry about is the texturing on the sides of the block. So now I can get rid of the blocks in the other three locations. Copy and clone. Grand. Now the texture's a bit screwed up on those, so let's move the texture on all of those blocks to somewhere where the texture's uniform. There we go. Oh, interesting, the legs have gotten a texture. Let me just select one of those legs and go. This is going to be fun, trying to get this bloody texture to line up with all these bloody vert points. So I think the easiest thing to do first is to scale it down using the surface inspector. And then move it up so you get the texture at the top and the texture at the bottom. Now I'm going to scale it vertically. So those dots and what am I doing? There we go. Sweet. Oh, that's an annoying thing. I thought Grebo would fix this. They're like, if I'm dragging these points or dragging all of them. Let me just try that again. Alright, it's behaving itself now, but sometimes when you move the mouse cursor off the edge of the texture window, it basically, the texture keeps on dragging and it's not supposed to do that. Oh, let's up this scale. Cut down one. Snap it all. Is that going to work or is that going to just balk it all? Yeah, I'm going to have to scale it vertically. Horizontally. So I can slot it in a space where... bollocks. Yeah, there's no way to do it. You'll either get that texture or that texture in amongst those two bits that I want. Oh well. Because what I want, I don't want those two patches, which I'm guessing is what the original modeler used. But I haven't got to spend time trying to do that. There we go. Yeah, and predictably it looks shit. Ah, that's annoying. So no way to do this without getting these things in on it. Maybe that was the texture. Alright, okay, let me try that. As in, that one was the foot. So let's scale it that way. Can't tell if that looks like the original model or not. Let's have a look. Yeah, that's definitely the texture that was used for those feet. And it even sort of looks like it does an original model. You know what? That'll fucking do. What's happened to my leg here? Oh, my legs have been resized. Can't have that. I need symmetry. Can't be having that. In fact, I don't know which one's not symmetrical now. Alright, let's move this one up to here and see. Right, so the other foot is the one that's symmetrical. Okay. Just Control Z to go back. You know what? I could spend time moving these bloody vert points about, or I could just nuke the flipping leg, copy the one that is correct, and then mirror it. Problem solved. Well, I do reckon that leg there, is that moved? Or is it just that one leg that got I somehow screwed up? Yeah, it was just that one leg. Grand. Right. No. And I moved the leg that I flipping spent all that time on doing the texture. Arse. You know what? In that case. Looks like I'm going to have to resize that leg. Because I'm not spending time moving those bloody textures about again. Easier just to move the vert points. They're all flipping all over the shop. Grand. I'll do. Just double check the texture. I see, I can move the textures up and down the leg, but I think it's this close to, in fact, I wonder if I even got this the right way around. I'll bet you I've got it the wrong way around. So that's the top of the leg and that's the bottom of the leg. All right, let's flip it round. Yeah, that's a bit more like it, isn't it? That'll do. Now I'm going to do is put the clone this leg and put it in the other three locations. Mirror Y. There we go. Happy days. Now down to do that one. So what I can do is, let's see if I can create a patch. What you can do is you can use a patch and you can create a brush and create a cylinder from a brush. So in this case, I'm going to go more cylinders, create square. Great, and it creates one on the outside. Let me hide that so I can get rid of the brush, put that back. Oh, what's going on there? There we go. There's our first cylinder. Now, what I want to do is drop that grid down. I'll put the thing in a place where, you know, I think I'm going to run just for simplicity's sake, trying to fuck about with the blank space in there and get it correct on all four pieces. I'm just going to the fuck. Oh, I see, because it's not a proper, it's a model texture, not a it's a model texture, not a non-model texture, which is why when I tried to top it or bottom it or left or right it, which would work with a non-model texture, this one just appears wherever the original model set. So I'm going to have to move it manually. All right, let's drop the grid down so that all the other vert points have got something to snap to. Grand. And then move this bottom one down. I'm hoping I don't have to move them all. I can just grab the two end bits and it'll move it. Yes. No. I have to grab those ones in the middle as well. Oh, there we go. I let go of the right mouse button and the texture was still moving. That's the problem. And I'm sure I filed that bug tracker with Grebo. You want to watch out for that. It's annoying. There we go. It's doing it again. Now, look, I've let go of the right click, the right hand mouse button. So I have to click it again. It's almost like there's no toggle option. Now, what I can do is do Control-Alt-T. No, not Control-Alt-T. So I'll do that. Control T and extrude that. Now I want to extrude it inwards, not outwards, so I'm going to give it a minus figure. Now I'm going to try a small one. And it's all normals. You'll see why in a minute. Nope, wrong way. Okay, so extrude it inwards then. Or a positive, I should say, not a negative. There we go. Now what I'll do is deselect that one, deselect that one, deselect the inner one, and then it gets rid of the top. Happy days. And there you go, perfectly done. Top, outside, and inner. Very, very nice. Now what, I don't like having that texture on the inside, so what can we do? Let's have a look in game. In the text editor. Oh, that's interesting. It's fucked about with the alignment. If we had another texture, wood texture that matched this table, a normal texture, i.e. a non-model texture, I would just copy that and paste that in there, but I don't think we have. So, let's just see if I can get away with this inside. Yeah, almost. The plan here is to hope that the player isn't going to really spend that much time on it and not notice the weird textures underneath. You know what? That'll do. Right, 1/6 place table. Right, almost. I've got to do these edges. And that resolution is far, far too high. What did I set it to? Is it 3 on the ends? 1, 2, 3, 4 and a bit, or just inside 4. Okay, that'll do. 1, 2, 3. So let's move that. Come on, shithead, move! Alright. I can do is you can turn grid off and go freestyle like that, but you've got to be extra careful with your texturing. Sorry, texture placement. Let's put the grid back on. And then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So there. Just give it. And let's do an 8 like I said. Is it the right same matching scale? Yes, it is. Days. And there's that one. No, it's the wrong way up. So let's move these down. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. The reason I'm trying to get it to grid is to try and get the texture roughly the same scale. So those the ends of the table look like they're roughly double the length of the ends. Doesn't have to be super accurate. Oh, no, I didn't mean to do that. But I didn't know you could do that. That was interesting. That would have saved me having to flip the texture around. Nice. Now, the only annoying thing here is that I have to line up all these textures by hand. So, move that up there. Grab those two there, drag it down like that, and then it lines up. And you've got that nice piece just there. That end piece there, though. And what is that? It's not even 1, 2, 3, 4, so it's already too long. There we go. I think what I might do is just have this trim here along that edge. It's annoying having that thing underneath there, that patch. It's done the same thing. I thought I fucking fixed this. Motherfucker. Yeah, that looks... I don't like the look of that. Right, let's see if there's a flipping wood texture that I can use for these end pieces, because this is beginning to bug me now. Media. Dark mod. Wood. Boards, I guess. What I'm looking for is something roughly the same colour that isn't a plank of wood. I might have to go to panels. Right. All the wrong textures. The wrong colour, hue. I can't use one of them because it's too rough. Get away with that one though, maybe. Nope. Totally the wrong colour. No, too dark. But the right hue, but too dark. Problem when you start using model textures, sometimes you'll come across a piece that you can't use. No. I might have to do what I did for the underpiece, the underside. Right hue, almost the right colour. But just not light enough. If what you could do is you could go and create your own material depth, but in this instance I'm not going to waste time doing that. Ah, there we go. That'll do. In fact, I could use that for the whole thing. Oh, I forgot about that little... That's the thing there. Look, it's matched perfectly in the corner, but not there. So what you have to do is grab these little vert points. So you don't get the Z fighting going on. There we go. Grand, and that looks as clean as all the other corners. Oh, I see, yes. It's a problem with extrusion algorithm on DR. It's not entirely accurate. But what I'm thinking is I can apply this pattern to that as well. Let's find out where that is on the model. Yeah, we don't want it there. We want it in the middle. And same thing here. Grand. Happy days. Yeah, from a distance. Don't worry about that weird shading thing you're seeing in DR. You won't see that in game. In fact, I can put that texture along the edge here. Because that was that even on the original? Not yet. So we need a plain one along the edge here. And that can be this one. And you can... let's see. Happy days. But I think what I'll do is... I'm going to use the dark trim of that other texture, so let's just bottom that out. There we go. Just move it up a smidge. Now it's too dark. What I could have got away with, I suppose, is more textures that match that than this. So I've kind of made my life difficult by doing this, but hey ho. In fact, let's top that one out. There we go. And then... no, not that way. There we go. Oh, shrunk it the wrong way. don't know if it looks too dark. I'm guessing in game it probably would be alright. But you know what? Let's try something else. Nice, still too stretched there, so let's change that to 15. No, in fact, you could do this. Yeah, no, that's just bloody stupid then. Alright, let's try 0.25. Alright, 0.3. Nice! Unfortunately, it looks right on the ends, but then not right everywhere else. Fucking hell, best laid plans and all. This is a way, can I cut the vert points? Yeah, alright, let me save the map in case it crashes while I do this split. See if I can split the patch that way. No. Yeah, so there's no way to do that because it's a single patch, so the only way I could do this would be to nuke that patch and then make remove the cylinder patch and then click on that button there, it creates a patch which we can then use instead, and then each patch side can then be individually, the texture scale can be individually applied, and it gets around that little problem. So now if I apply this texture to it, oh yeah, now 10 and 15 is too high. That's why the scaling was all over the bloody shop, because it was a single square. So now I can probably go to 6 on that one. No, it looks like it's going to have to be an 8. There we go. Oh, there's not much going on there. I'm fucking about trying to fix it. I'm just going to copy it. And then control I to change the face. Which way out it's facing there, watch. See, it changes which side the texture faces out from. Grand. I think I'm happy with that. What I'm going to do, though, is save me having to, so I don't have to go and create this table again on the next map I work on. I'm going to save it into my prefabs folder. Oh, interesting. It's slightly off. There it was perfect on 4 grids, but there it's moved out a smidge. So I'm going to grab all of them and move them in. Just because I'm anal when it comes to getting things all lined up perfectly. So there, 2 from there, 2 from there. And the dots in the middle line up almost perfectly. So that means there's some sizing. See those 2 little dots there? I'd like them to appear on that center line, and it'd mean everything is equidistant from one end to the other. But it does mean somewhere, something is slightly longer on one side, i.e. on the right-hand side. So 4 there, 2 there. Let's go up down to 2. Those ones don't line up. That could be what the issue is. No. There we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, that's 5. Let's move that to there. Just because. I like symmetry. Oops. And it's equidistant. There it is. Good. So why aren't these ones snapping in the middle? Well, now. Oh, no. Gone too far down. There we go. But interestingly, so 1, 2, and so 2's at 4, 1, 2, and then obviously, and then a single bit at 2. What's this? 1, 2. So yeah, that leg is over that far. That's what the problem is. That's annoying. So maybe these legs are a different shape to those legs. There, look, you can see that's one at grid 8, another one at grid 8, and then one at 2. This one is over by 4. Yeah, can't be having that. So let's get rid of that now because I don't need it. The reason I'm dragging it down here and placing it in the 0, 0 is that one of the map is when I export this as a prefab to my prefabs collection folder, and the one for this map, it'll always appear in the center of the prefab viewer. Something screw. Ah, there we go. There's where the screw up is. Look, the distance there between that one and that line there is bigger than it is there. It's 3. So I need to grab everything, hide all that, and move it in. Happy days. Now we have a perfectly symmetrical table. For 6 people, and with no hidden surfaces. So basically the only brush for this entire thing is that top piece, because it's just easier. I could have created this whole thing out of patches. All right, let's rejig that one. Oh, don't be a shit. Must be that one that's being annoying. No, the whole fucking thing wants to rejig. One of these things I'm going to have to do a proper reproduction of so that Grebo can at least attempt to, or has a fair shake at fixing it. The camera zooming in and out, you can see I'm clipping into the model, which is no good. So what you can do is use the plus and minus to change your moving in amount. There we go. It does mean when you're scrolling, you have to scroll quite a lot, but it's helpful when I can zoom right in to see where a texture's lining up. Oh. Needs to be flipped round, so I can do this. Grand. Right, one table. Oh, that one's slightly off. Let's trim that down a bit. Oh no, it wasn't. It was fine. It was just this bit that it wasn't. So undo that. It was the edge of that that I was seeing. Hello.
Hey, what's up? I might have been doing something at the moment. Give me a quarter of an hour and I'll give you a call back. Alright, speak to you in a bit.
Right, where were we? Well, we have 45 minutes to work on a bloody model. Christ. Right, so there's my table. Export as prefab. All right, well, I'm going to put it in here anyway, so we'll call this 6. In fact, you know what? Let's cancel that. What's the existing table called? Right. It's called Dining Table Medium, so we're going to call this one Double Taint. I'll try that and pronounce that again. We'll call it Small 01. Turn the bloody caps lock off. Get rid of the ASC. In fact, let's just spell that properly, shall we? Happy days. Now, the other thing you can do, which I will do as well, we can export this as a model. Now, hopefully, the exporting doesn't bork up all my bloody textures. Otherwise, we'll have to use the prefab version. So, export, where is it? Export ASE. Give it a name. Small one. Save path. No, I want to put it in the folder that we've just, this game, this map. Where are we? Cleaning. Stop being a dick, computer! The fuck? Why doesn't it let me create a folder in there? Oh, do it the fucking hard way then, computer. Oh, it did, but... Oh, Windows 7 being a shit. Ugh. One of the things I never know. What are you doing? Fucking hell. Windows 7. Some things are great. Some things are totally shit. There we go. If you have a folder where... a model where you've created it like I've done in DR. And it's full of... brushes, and most of the cut faces have got caulk on them. You can do that. You can if you want the caulk in there, you can. But most people don't. When you export a model, you want to have as minimum. That's the wrong word. You don't want to export all the hidden faces because it's just wasted render time then for the engine. You can export the things at the origin, but I don't tick that because I've already got it at the origin 000. So when I appear flat it in game, I've got the origin there. Now, if you ticked on that tick box, it probably put the origin of the model somewhere in the middle, so that when you floor the object, in this case a table, to the floor, it will go through the floor, and you don't want that. So in this case, I'm just going to go blam. Now, let's go reload models. And let's go into the dining room. We should be able to change that. Now, when you... Another good working practice is, and I should have just done that just now, so apologies, but what you're supposed to do is create the same folder structure as in the dark mod. So in this case, models, dark mod, furniture, tables. Now, I can't spell to save my life. It's furniture. Furniture. Yep. What's the next bit? Tables. Typing too quick. Then what we do is move that model in there. Reload models again. Well, when I go choose model, dial table small. Ah, there's another one in there. Now, why isn't my one appearing in the thing? And did it bork up all my textures? No, it's come out perfectly. Happy days. Oh, I'm an idiot. There's why, because the origin is there. I got it right there and forgot to move it over. Now, there we go. Is that in the middle? Yes, it is. Now, when I export it, it'll be in the bloody middle and viewable in the... There we go. Reload models. I can get rid of this. Unless the... I'll just hide the plates for now. Get rid of the brush here. Brushes that I made for the resized table. Insert model. Oh, for some reason, it's still not appearing in the middle. Why? Fucking hell. I've done it wrong again somehow. No, 0, 0, 0. It's smack in the middle where it's supposed to be. I think what I have to do is maybe convert it to a func static first before exporting it. Change the vert point, sorry, the origin point, so it's where I want it to be. In the middle of the desk, but at floor level. Now export it. Yes. In fact, let me save that prefab just in case I get bored. I don't want to deal with it anymore. Reload the models again. In fact, I can get rid of a couple of these places. Ah, oh, fuck you, DR. You know what? Let me just save them. I don't know what the fuck it's doing. I'm exporting it correctly. Sometimes you have to go out in and out of DR for it to behave itself. No, it's still fucking miles away from the origin. Welcome to DR. Oh, that one's appearing in the right spot. Oh, hang on. I'm being a knob. See what I mean, buddy? I know what I was doing. I wasn't exporting it to where I thought I was exporting it to. Yep, I'm an idiot. I was exporting it to the root of the models folder. So now that's the correct one. Right, I can get rid of that now. Just double check. So if we go, if I reload models, it should probably go, oh, and change that. It does, that's fine. Then we'll point it at the right location. So furniture, tables, small O1, blam. And then we have a model, just like all the other models. But six way. What the f... There we go. Happy days. Alright, I'm going to leave it there for now. I just thought I'd show you this little trick for making your own models based off the existing models. But my nephew's phoned up. I've got to fix their bloody iMac for them. Via TeamViewer, so I'm going to leave it there for now, and I'll come back with another vid after I've done a bit of work, because I have to think about how I'm going to do this dining room. I'm thinking either that table can go through there, that becomes part of the dining room, move this fireplace to there, and then this whole area there becomes the VIP room, and then put between there and there, put some arches so the player can walk through like as a nice flow of space, and leave that door where it is. That sounds like a plan. Right, I'll see you again later on this afternoon.